Good morning, Dr. Lim here. So now we are going to talk about hexagenous reflexology. Over the year in this genotherapy, we have seen many reaction, many reaction from the body, and we say that from the external manifestation, we should able to analyze what is happening inside the body. Most of the reflexology are two-dimensional. Or like the palm, or they call it the sole of the leg, this thing is two-dimensional. But we need a three-dimensional reflexology, to link outside and inside. So over the year, we have established this science, of three-dimensional reflexology. And in this video, I'm going to talk about this reflexology. Hexagenous reflexology is a big project. So in this video, we just have some introduction to it. So you just to let you to understand some general concept of hexagenous reflexology. Hexa means six, no? Hexagenous reflexology, it means it is a six-section reflexology. This is a three-dimensional reflexological system. Now we map the whole body, using this elliptical coordinate system. I'm going to show it in this future slide. From one area of the body, we can mesh to the other part of the body. For example, the eye is related to the liver and etc. etc. Then from external symptoms and reactions, we can study the health problem inside the body. And that's very important because when you take genotherapy, when people come to see you, you can only see the external symptoms. And by studying the external symptoms, we should be able to know what is the problem inside the body. From the surface of the body, then we can use acupuncture, we can use massage, or we can even apply genotherapy, apply the herbs on the surface, no? To treat the internal problem. You may ask how we discover the hexagenous system. In the early day of genotherapy, we need a reflexological system to explain the body reactions. There's so many reactions, after taking genotherapy. And how are we going to explain that, So we need to map the body using a simple system that everybody can learn. And you need not memorize, no? Memorize all the reflection zones and acupuncture points. That is not practical for the teaching to the public. So we need a simple system, no? That anybody can learn and learn it quickly. And also our system should mesh with modern anatomy. So when you study the system, it should link to the modern anatomy, So that this study will become useful for the modern day. I explain a little bit about yin and yang. Many people have some mystical thinking about yin and yang. He thought that there's something mystic, in the oriental teaching. No, no, no. Yin and yang actually is a very simple concept. What is inside, is yin. What is outside is yang. What is deficient is yin. What is excessive is yang. So it's like a plus and minus, no? This in the mathematics. So the reaction from the body can be internal and external, and deficient in metabolism or excessive in metabolism. So we define yin as something internal and deficient. Then the patient, he'll talk softly or he doesn't want to talk at all. So emotionally he is withdrawn, he's sitting there quiet and general weakness in energy. Yang is external and excessive in metabolism. The patient talk loudly and excitedly and emotionally agitated. Movement is quick and sometimes become violent. This is yang. Now, how we define the hexagenous system? You see, the body can be divided into external, internal, and something intermediate. So they are the three level of the body. So these are the three major sections associated with the body. Each section can has external or internal symptoms like body pains, skin problem are external. Then abdominal pains inside the body, low appetite or weak digestive are internal. So each section has deficient or excessive metabolism. So deficient is yin and excessive is yang. Some people pronounce it as yang. It's up to you, but in the original Chinese pronunciation, it's pronounced as yang. And each section, we divide into yin and yang. And from three sections, okay, from external, intermediate, internal, then each section we divide into yin and yang. So totally, we have six systems. That's why we call it hexagenous system. Coming to the naming of the system, external section, we call it exogenous system. Exo means external. Intermediate section, we call it interogenous. Intero means intermediate. So internal section, we call it endogenous system. Endo means inside. So each section associated with yin and yang. So totally we get six sections. We have external one, we have exo-yin and exo-yang. So the intermediate one, we have intero-yin and intero-yang. And inside is endo-yin and endo-yang. So this is quite simple in definition. So you please study this, okay, try to understand this. I think it is simple to understand. The six section theory is first proposed by Zhang Zhongjing. About 2000 years ago, no? Zhang Zhongjing is a very famous ancient doctor, and he write a very famous technical book called Sang Han Lun, the treatise on the harmful disease. And until today, his book still the textbook, you know, for the TCM, the traditional Chinese medicine. So Zhang Zhongjing lived around 150 to 219 CE. During the Roman Empire times. And he divided the body into six sections. You know. So external yang, he called it the major yang or tai yang. Or external yin, he called it the minor yin or sao yin. So intermediate yang, he called it the minor yang or sao yang. Intermediate yin, he called it weak yin or jue yin. Internal yang, he called it bright yang or yang ming. Internal yin, he call it the major yin, the tai yin. Of course, the naming system is not the same as us, but the correspondent is almost the same. Okay, and this naming system is a little bit complicated. That's why I use it in a modern way of the exo, intero, and endo. That may be easier for you to learn. So this is Zhang Zhongjing and the book written by him, the Sang Han Lun. And Zhang Zhongjing, you can know, actually, we love him very much. He is my most respected ancient doctor, okay? And he is full of love, you know, okay? In his time, to write things now is not easy. They use the bamboo strip and they use a small knife, you know, to cut and cave down the wording. It may take him years, you know, to write down this Sang Han Lun. Even today, we want to study, also take a long time to study, not to say to cave it on the bamboo. Okay, and Zhang Zhongjing, to us as a therapist, he is our spiritual, almost like a spiritual endorsement to us. So many times when I compile the genotherapy, I compile the teaching, everything, I feel tired and all. Okay, then I think of him. I say, wow, he is such a good doctor, okay? Spent so much time to put down his thing onto this Sang Han Lun, onto the right thing, and open source, no. He never touched, he never asked any money, he never keep anything a secret, he's not so secretive, he get nothing from it, and the son and daughter, okay, also do not get any benefit from it. It's pure, no, dedication for the mankind. So we respect him very much. In the TCM, each section is further divided into two. Okay, now each section is associated with a solid organ, they call it Zhang, and the hollow organs, they call it Fu. For example, liver is solid inside, and associated with liver is a gallbladder. So liver is solid, we call it Zhang, gallbladder is hollow, we call it Fu. Another example is kidney and bladder. Kidney is solid inside, we call it Zhang. Bladder is hollow inside, we call it Fu. Now, this six section is divided into the famous 12 variants. It's formed the basic diagnosis system for TCM. Okay. Now, all the disease, And all the herbs, no, are systematically classified into eight meridians. The whole body is mapped by the meridians, and acupuncture is applied on the meridians. This is the existing system which apply until today. Okay, it's very famous system. The 12th meridian, no, is so successful, and it's even applied until today, you know. And Zhang Zhongjing compiled all the symptoms into six sections, and each meridian in his famous medical treaty, the Sang Han Lun, the discussion to treat harmful disease. I'm going to have a series now on this Sang Han Lun that is on the separate training when you want to learn about herbs and formulation. The system is so successful, it is even used today as a major body system in TCM. Okay, so Sang Han Lun become the oldest medical book which is still widely learned by the TCM student even until today. Okay, and the diagnostic technique and the herbal formula, it form the backbone of the modern day TCM. So Zhang Zhongjing is the father of TCM. If the six session theory of Zhang Zhongjing is so good and used until today, then why don't we use it in our organotherapy? We have a few problems. Okay, first, it's complicated a lot. You have to spend a few years to study the meridians and the acupuncture point. There are a few hundred acupuncture points, no? Okay, and each point have their own function and their own implication. Each meridian also have their own function and their own applications. So it takes you many years to study that. And secondly, it does not associate with the modern anatomy, and we need a three-dimensional reflexology, you know, and this one is not, okay. Thirdly, the naming is complicated, you know, and it's not systematic like this. The minor yang, sao yang is intermediate, but the minor yin, sao yin is external. Okay, sometimes the naming is complicated, and the meridian are not in a straight line. You know, it detail halfway, and you have to memorize it. It's not a straight line. And in our hexagenous system, we put a clock line. You know, all a straight line. Okay, easy to memorize. And finally, there are so many acupuncture points, though. Oh, it takes a long time for the student to memorize. And many people after the second year, they already forgotten what they learned in the first year, though. So I've seen some students already spending 3 to 4 years to learn acupuncture, though, and they can't even acupuncture properly. Okay, and in our hexagenous system, 3 to 4 days only they can start to apply acupuncture. So there is a lot of difference between the approach. Even though the basic theory is the same, but the approach is very different. In the early day, I try to teach acupuncture. The student, especially the non-Chinese, now immediately confused by the names. No, even the major section, you know, the naming of Tai Yang, Sao Yang, Yang Ming, Sao Yin, Jue Yin, Tai Yin, no, confuse the student immediately, including the young Chinese, no, or not to say the non-Chinese. And it takes the student too much time to learn the name and trace the path of the meridians and memorize the function of each meridians and the points, which unfortunately also do not correlate with the modern anatomy. Many TCM scholars, you know, try to coordinate, you know, the this thing with the modern anatomy with catastrophic result. Why we say that the TCM system is very difficult to associate with modern anatomy? For example, the liver system is associated with the blood metabolism. Okay, and it's more than the function of the anatomy in the liver system. No, here I use a capital letter L liver to mean that it's a macro system. No, it's not referring to the anatomy liver inside the body. Now, the spleen in a TCM is designated as a digestive organ, but in modern day, the spleen is more associated with the blood. You know, it's a graveyard of blood cell. When your blood dies, it is accumulated in the spleen, and after that, it's break down. So where is collected the dead blood and decompose it for recycle? Actually, the spleen is more attuned to the liver function of TCM rather than the digestive system. No? And the liver organs, anatomy organ, is important for the digestive organ. So it is more associated with the spleen system in TCM rather than the liver system. So if you try to associate the ancient naming and the modern anatomy, you know, you always get errorless result. We need a modern system to map the body, you know. Okay, now if someone tell you the lesser known name of some place, no, wow, you have to go to the web and searching high and low, where is the place? But if we give you the GPS, no, immediately you can identify the area. So we need not memorize the name of the countless towns and cities, no, as long as you know the GPS. So we should develop a mapping system on the body where the location can be immediately identified without the need to memorize the meridians and the point. But we cannot develop a completely different system than the six-axis theory of Zhang Zhongjing, you know, because the six-axis theory is so well established. You can learn so many things from the six-axis theory of TCM. That's why our method also cannot run deviated too much from the six-axis theory. But at the same time, you know, it must correlate with the modern anatomy. Okay, so our hexagenous theory one, you learn it. So next time when you want to study Sang Han Lun or the TCM, it should match well, no, in your future study. Okay, you no need to relearn and redo everything. That is very difficult. And secondly, since the ancient theory had nothing to do with the modern day anatomy, no, but our system must match with the modern day anatomy. Okay, so the mapping should coordinate well to the modern anatomy so that you can study it systematically. Many people say this is not possible. No? How can you match the ancient one and the modern one? There's no such thing as impossible in our dictionary. You know, okay, all these things we must find a way to coordinate the two. At first, I thought the mapping is easy. After all, our body is cylindrical in shape, you know. Why not we just use the cylindrical coordinates? So at first, I define the line on the cylinder. Okay, the top is like a clock, you know. Then we have 12 o'clock. Okay, and maybe at the back, our back is 12 o'clock. Our front is 6 o'clock. Our left side is 3 o'clock, and our right side is 9 o'clock. Just like a clock, you know. You're putting a cross section of the clock on your body. But the problem is that the clock line do not match well with the meridian lines. Okay, I spent many years now, try to modify, try to change the shape, try to do everything. It never work. Okay, if the cross-section of the body is look like a clock, then the meridian should match with the major clock lines. Okay, like the 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, etc. But unfortunately, if it's just a simple cylindrical system, the meridian match the minutes line, not the hour line. And it makes the study complicated if we use this system. Now, you look at the left, there's a schematic drawing of our cross section. You excuse me for this rough drawing. I'm not very good in this computer graphic, you know. But this is a rough idea about the cross section, you know, in the thorax section, you know. Okay, you compare to the top right, the clock, it doesn't match, you know. It doesn't match. Okay, and it doesn't look the same. So that troubles a lot. For years, you know, I tried to modify the clock system, it never worked. Then until one day, you know, after looking at the cross section, suddenly I some idea come to me, you know. Maybe the body is the intersection of two clocks, you know. Okay, then they intersect at 11 o'clock and 7 o'clock. Then it looked more like the cross section of the body. You see, you compare to the left, top left and top right, it looked more like to each other now. Then I superimpose in the cross section of the body. Oh yeah, it matched very well, you know. It matched very well. That's why our cross section of the body actually is a superimpose of two clock. It's not one clock, you know. That is very, very important. You always have to remember this. This is the schematic drawing of the two clock. This you must always remember this, you know. Look at it until you understand what it is, because this is the basic of our hexagenous reflexology. Now, the clock section of the main body is like the intersection of two clock, and you look at that, they intersect at 11 and 7 o'clock. Okay, you look at the right hand side and left hand side, you know, the left hand side is the mirror image of the right hand side. Okay, the right hand side, the 3 o'clock is at the right, but the left hand side, the 3 o'clock is at the left, you know. Okay, the right hand side is a common clock that you are seeing, but the left hand side is a mirror. It's a mirror, you know. It's a mirror. Then they intersect at 11 o'clock and at 7 o'clock in below. Okay, now you look, 1, 3, 5 is always outside. Okay, 7, 9, 11 is always inside. So 1, 3, 5 is the yang line and 7, 9, 11 is a yin line. Okay, this is the basic classification of line. So when we intersect two circle, you find that the hour line match well with meridian. Okay, so in the future, when we teach hexagenous reflexology in acupuncture, we can show that our hour line covered almost all the acupuncture points and match well with the meridians. Okay, this is very important discovery and excited me very much since then. Okay, and I use it to explain the reflexology in kinotherapy. And I also use this system, you know, to explain the Sang Han Lun, which we are going to teach you in the future. Just now we talked about the cross section of the body. How about the elevation? Okay, you look at the body, you know. Okay, that also you're very careful. So the main body of a man, it looks like intersection of four ellipses. On top the thorax, on top the chest is a bigger, then slim down to the waist, and then expand again in the hip, you know. So it looks like the intersection of four ellipses. That also very important. Okay, you must always study this. I use the muscle system to indicate the body surface because muscle you can identify it clearly. Okay, so I spent a few hours now to sketch out this muscle schematic drawing of the body. From here we can identify easily, you know, where is the locality on top of the body surface. Now we superimpose the four ellipses into the main body, and you can see it match very well, no, with the body. Okay, and this is the most important matching. You should always remember this well. Now we are going to study the main body, nah. So this is the main muscle of our chest, of the thorax, abdomen, and the pelvic section. Okay, these are the main section of the body, and in reflexology we need to study this section first. Before we superimpose the four ellipses into the body again, okay, you just roughly see the left hand side. Okay, this is the muscle system, and the right hand side, this is the four ellipses. No, then we are going to superimpose these two together. Okay, finally we superimpose the two. Okay, so it meshed very well. Now you see on the top, it seems that the body is slightly bigger than the two ellipses. No, actually it's not. Whatever you see that it is a back muscle. No, that's back part of the muscle. The front part it meshed perfectly with the four ellipses. What is you see extra? The one is a back part of the body. Also, you see the four ellipses are naturally divided the body into three sections. Okay, the top section is the thorax, the second section is the abdomen, the third section is the pelvic. This mesh well with the anatomy. Now, this is the internal organs of the body, and you can see that our four ellipses mesh very well. I can identify the area very, very clearly, you know. And you can see the lung. Okay, it's at the two intersections at the top, and the heart is right in the middle. When you come to the abdomen system, now, then you can identify the liver and the stomach, okay, very clearly. You cannot see this, the kidney is at the back, okay. Then, of course, you can see the colon, the small intestine clearly. This is purely on the internal organs, okay? And you can try to identify the organs easily. Try to commit this picture into memory. This is the most important picture, okay, for our hexagenous theory. Now, we are showing the muscle and also the internal organs of the body. So the muscle is the external, the organ is the internal. So this photo, you have to keep on looking at it, you know, okay, until you feel familiar with the muscle and also with the internal organs, is to link the external to the internal. So I'm going to give this slide and everything to all the branches, okay, so you all in the future should be able to get the slide and also the photo free of charge, okay, and this one, keep on looking at it, you know, until you familiar with this four ellipses. You can learn a lot, you know, from this four ellipses picture. Okay, so that the body is divided into three sections. The upper section is the thorax, the mid section is the abdomen, okay, the lower section is the pelvic. Now, the body, sometimes we say that the body external, intermediate, and internal. No? Sometimes it's also true that the body can divide into three sections, no? The thorax section, the abdomen section, the pelvic section. Okay, so sometimes the thorax section refers to the external section, the abdominal section refers to the internal section, and then the pelvic section is the endosystem. Okay, so these are the three areas. Then for the thorax, thorax divided into three sections, you know. Okay, so then you can see that the lungs are at left and right, then the heart are in the middle. This is for the thorax. So these are the mid and lower body. The mid body is the abdominal section, or we so say the abdomen. Okay, and there are seven topical area. Okay, is seven, because of the four ellipse, no, you get seven area. And you can see the two big one look like the eye, you know? So we nickname the eye. It look like the eyes on the four ellipse. Okay, the top section cover liver, stomach in the front, and kidney at the back. Okay, then the lower section cover colon and part of the intestine. So in the pelvic section, and you can see that the colon is at the side. Okay, then this intestine, the small intestine, is at the center. Okay, then at the lower section, there are also the bladder and also the womb for the woman, but it is not shown here. But you can get it easily, you know, from any anatomy picture. From here, then you can study the refraction. Okay, you look at the up and down, or the thorax section and the this pelvic section. You see the lung reflected to the colon, you know. Okay, the heart is to the small intestine. That's why in the reflexology we say that the colon and lung link together, heart and the small intestine. From here, you can know it immediately. So even when you study TCM, you know, they say that the lung is related to colon, the heart is related to small intestine, but there's no explanation. But from here, you can see clearly why the lung is associated with the colon, why the heart is associated with this intestine. Now, this three section, sometimes you can reword it. You can turn it 180 degree, you know, okay, then it's still the same. Okay, so the reaction, it can be top down and bottom ups. And also the front and the back, and the left to the right. Okay, so the liver and gallbladder is a left to the right, this thing. The stomach and pancreas also is a right to the left. Okay, then the kidney and the bladder is a front to the back. Okay, this is also the normal reflection. Now, this is the important picture to match the whole face, no, to the whole body. Okay, now the face is also the superimposed on the four ellipse. It's not two ellipses, no, four ellipses on the face. Okay, so that our whole face can map to the whole organs. Okay, then this, you study this carefully. This is very important diagrams. When you study the four ellipse on the face, no, you see from the picture, it seems that the four ellipse on the top is smaller than the head. Actually, it's not, you know, because the head are three-dimensional, and we are showing the two-dimensional. So what you see, the examiner is at the back of the head. It's not in the front. Okay, so when you look at the front, it matches perfectly. Okay, it matches perfectly when the thing is inside the front. Now, from this picture, then you can know how the organ is mapped on the face. So the lung is reflected into both sides of the forehead. Okay, so some people sometimes they have this a headache, you know, at the side of the forehead, then you suspect it is a lungs a problem. And the lung also go into slightly into the eyes, you know. Okay, so when there is a water congestion in the lung, the water going down to the lung, okay, is reflected on the eye. So the teary eye, you know, is also mean that there is water congestion inside the lung, okay, at the lower part of the lung, because the lower part of the lung actually go into the eye. Okay, then you see the heart. The heart is at the central forehead. So when the people are having this central forehead problem, this headache, everything, is a heart. So when you rub the central forehead softly, you know, so you can also strengthen the heart. Now, another one is very important one. You look at the liver. The liver mesh well into the eye. Okay, these are the things. So we always say that the liver is reflected on the eye. From here you can see it very clearly. Okay, then the mouth in the small intestine. Okay, and the small intestine is reflected to the heart. So this is a secondary reflection alone. So the mouth reflected to the intestine, intestine reflected to the heart. That's why the tongue inside the mouth, no? Okay, this is a secondary, this thing is reflected to the heart. That's why we say that the tongue in the mouth are associated with the heart. Okay, then the stomach also reflected just below the eye. Just below the eye. That's why the lower part of the eye, you know, or when the thing is swollen, everything, then you see there's something wrong, weakness in the stomach. Okay, then of course the kidney is at the back. Okay, it reflected on around the muscle of the eye. Okay, so when around the muscle of the eye become dark, become the panda eye, then this is the kidney problem. Now for the limbs, for the legs, and also for the hand, they are just two ellipses, no? It's not four ellipses, remember. Okay, the two ellipses, then the intersection at the fold, knee and the fold. So for the limbs, it's intersection of the two ellipses. So the right side of the limbs is to the two ellipses of the right of the body. Okay, now by pressing the hand and leg, you know, and checking on the color of the surface, okay, and by checking some lump or something abnormality at the surface of the hand and leg, then we can know what is wrong inside the organs. Okay, and this is also the basic of our acupuncture in the future. Okay, so that the internal organs, they can reflect on the face and so on the limb. By checking the face, by checking the limbs, no, okay, we can know what is inside the body. And of course, this is a big study. Today is the introduction. So when in the future, when we come for the massage, no, hexagenous massage and also the acupuncture, we are going to discuss more details on that. Now, by study the two ellipses in the hand and the body, so you can see the simple mapping, you know. So the lung is mapping to the upper arms and the upper body, and the heart is at the upper arm but interior, you know, interior this this thing, and also at the thigh. Okay, then the liver, the stomach, kidney are at the joint. Okay, so that when we say that those people have a liver problem, a weak knee, how do you know a person having a kidney problem? You ask him to squat, you know, when ask him to stand up, he take him a lot of effort to stand up. That means at the back of the knee, you know, is weak. Let me know that, oh, the kidney is weak. Okay, and some people, they always complain of the knee pains. No, don't treat the knee, don't treat the knee, you know, treat the kidney and treat the stomach. It's not the knee problem. Okay, now, and the colon and intestine also at the end, towards the sole of the legs, okay? Then the palms of hand and the leg also reflected to the genital area. Okay, that's why many people also know when you study reflexology, you study the sole of the legs, no? That reflected to the lower abdomen and also the genital layer of the body, and this is the reason. When come to the reflexology, you know, sometimes the reverse is also true. Okay, for example, so the palm and sole can be the genital area, okay, but it also can represent the head, you know. So the area between the palm and sole to the ellipse can be represent the neck area. So when the people having cough, having neck problem, we go and check this area, you know, and there's some painful point, and we rub the area, and it can relieve the cough. Okay, then the liver, stomach, and kidney in the mid of the section, it doesn't change. Okay, but the colon, intestine, and womb also become opposite. So that the reverse order is also true in reflexology. And today, you don't need to worry that much. We are going to discuss about it in great details in the future. Up to now, we have shown the picture for the man, and also mainly on the male surface. Now, how about women? Okay, and also we only sew in the front, we never sew at the back. Now you look at the woman's bodies, it also fits very well. into this the section of the girls. Okay, now this picture, we saw the vein, we saw this thing, it doesn't look that tightly, you know. Okay, because if you saw the beautiful and new photo like this in Malaysia, I may go to jail, you know. So this is the normally in a medical system, we are showing the picture in this way. Okay, then also at the back, you can see the kidney, you know, kidney also inside the both the eye. I thought this thing, then you can see the rectum. Okay, study these two pictures well. So we're coming to the end of the video now. Okay, this is our many years of study, you know, in this hexagenous reflexology. And today what you see is just a summary and introduction. Okay, you look at the body, you know, when you study the body, sometimes you have to imagine this line. This line is 7 o'clock. It's not 6 o'clock, you know, 7 o'clock. And at the back there is 11 o'clock. 12 o'clock is at the side there. So that you see the body in front. Okay, this is 6 o'clock is here. 6 o'clock and 5 o'clock is going through the nipples. 5 o'clock going through the rear. And 3 o'clock at the side. So between 3 o'clock and 4 o'clock, between 3 and 5 is 4 o'clock. It's very easy. Then for the hand, and for the hand, remember, here is a. It's a stomach area. Okay, that's why in this acupuncture, when people have a stomach a problem, no, we always check around this area, especially this area, no. We press it, you know, you press it. This is a stomach problem, and you press it. Sure, you can get some point painful here. This thing. So this is when we teach this acupuncture, we are going to that. So I am going to have another video to introduce the acupuncture point and everything. Okay, and today we may talk a lot, so even you do not understand in the beginning, never mind, look at it again and again. Okay, I am sure after some time you get familiar with all these things, and this information we are going to distribute to you. Okay, actually this video we are based on the slide, you know. Okay, so I'm going to send the slide out to the branches so that you can get the slides. And you can also get the pictures, everything. It's free of charge now. We don't charge you anything on that. Okay. Then you can translate into the local language if you want. Okay. Study well. Okay. And I hope you enjoy the thing. See you again in the next video.